So Patrick Mahomes just got a slight raise. You may have heard about it. He can make $503 million over the course of his new contract, and all he has to do is win 10 MVPs and 10 AFC championships. Which, of course, nobody has done. Let's talk about that. So, how is this deal actually worth $503 million? Earlier this season, the Chiefs exercised the fifth-year option on Mahomes' rookie contract, keeping him in Kansas City for the next two seasons and paying him around $27 million total. Add that to the 10-year contract extension, which is worth about $451 million without incentives, and you come to the 10-year, $478 million contract. The final $25 million is incentive-based and will start in 2022. Each year, Mahomes can make an additional $1.25 million for winning MVP and another $1.25 million for winning an AFC championship. This additional $25 million brings the total to just under $503 million. So, unless he wins 10 MVPs and 10 AFC championships, he's not actually going to earn $503 million. This deal was surprising to many, not just because of the size, but of the length and the terms of the contract. This deal had an unusually small $10 million signing bonus, which is dwarfed by Russell Wilson's $65 million signing bonus, and had only $63 million guaranteed at signing, which is fifth all-time. Instead of a larger amount guaranteed at signing, Mahomes and the Chiefs opted for rolling guarantees, which many refer to as guaranteed mechanisms. On the third day of each league year, if Mahomes is on the roster, he collects guarantees of salary or roster bonuses two seasons in advance through 2025, and 1 year in advance thereafter. These rolling guarantees are common, but never for a contract of this length. While at the surface it might not look like it, this contract is reasonably team-friendly. By slowly easing into the massive increase, the contract will grow with the salary cap. Compare it with other recent quarterback deals, and it seems like a bargain, at least for the next few years. No quarterback has ever won a Super Bowl while taking up more than 14% of the salary cap. In 1994, Steve Young won the Super Bowl with 13.1%. Mahomes has two or three years before passing that threshold. Can Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs break the trend?